Hi to all. Today we discuss about the tabulation of data and also frequency tables. Okay. So tabulation of data. So what is tabulation of data? Tabulation data means it's a process of orderly arrangement of data into series of rows and columns where they can be read in two dimensions. It's a tabulation of data. It's a process of orderly arrangement of into series of rows and columns where they can read into two dimensions. That means we can read very easily when they appear into the two dimensions. So it's a tabulation of data. So here, a tabular arrangement make the summation of items and detection of errors and omissions easier. Why we are using this tabulation data means it makes the arrangement of the summation of items and detection of any errors, okay, and also identification of omissions is very easy. And why it's need, why the tabulation is need means it's a table which is a systematic arrangement of statistical data into columns and rows. A table is a systematic arrangement of statistical data into columns and rows, and this tables makes it possible for the analyst to present the huge mass of data in a detailed order manner within minimum space. An analyst can explain its complete data with a minimum space. That's why we are using these tables to explain a huge mass of data in a minimum space. And it's a presentation of raw data is the cornerstone of statistical reporting. For statistical reporting, why it is need means it is helps to arrange the information in columns and rows, means in a systematic arrangement of statistical data in columns and rows, and the tables makes it possible for the analyst to present a huge mass of the data, simplifies in a minimum space, and the tabular presentation of raw data, and it is the cornerstone of the statistical reporting. And next, significance means it's a simplifies the complex raw data, which is this tables are simplifies the complex of raw data, and it is helps to or facilitates to comparison between the two different variables of a parameters. Means we can easily compare two different variables with the help of the tables. And what rules we have to follow to form tabulation? So the rules are, the table should be suit the size of the paper, usually with more rows than columns. And all tables, okay, in all tables we must mention the numbers, heading and subheading should be mentioned in a systematic order, such as alphabetical order or chronological order, etc. So we must mention the numbers, heading, subheading, etc. should be arranged in systematic order, such as alphabetical and also chronological order. And the points of measurements should be clearly defined in the given table. Means where we have to mention about length or weight, etc. So here we have to mention the length in the centimeters in particular given table. About weight we have to mention the grams. And the table should not be overloaded with details, rather than a number of tables should be prepared. So each table should be complete in itself and serve a particular purpose. So the rules are, the table should suit the size of the paper, usually with more rows than columns. And in all tables we have to mention the numbers, heading and subheading should be mentioned in systematic order, like such as alphabetical order or chronological order or attributes, etc. So the next one, the points of measurement should be mentioned very clearly defined and given in the particular table, such as length or weight. So length we have to mention in the centimeters and weight we have to mention in the grams. And next, the table should not be overloaded with the details, rather a number of tables should be prepared. So each table should be complete itself and serve a particular purpose. And next, types of tables. So here two types of tables are there. One is the simple and complex tables, another one general and summary tables. Two types of tables are there. One is the simple and complex tables, another one general and summary tables. So the first one, simple and complex table. So simple table means here only one characteristic is shown. It's called one way table, or it's called as simple table, where only one characteristics will be shown. It's called as one way table or simple table. And means here it has got two factors will be placed in relation each other. Okay, so example, like here we have to pick the example like as this table. So here we have to mention the length of 57 papaya plants. Okay, so here this length of plants is completely related to number of plants present in that particular garden. So 1 to 5 centimeters of plants, 2 plants are present, and 6 to 10 centimeters, 5 plants are present, and 11 to 15 centimeters, 10 plants are present, and 16 to 20 centimeters of length, 11 plants are present in that garden. So means the length of the plant and the number of plants both are completely in relation each other. Another one, complex tables means two or more characteristics are shown in a table. It's called complex table. Okay, two or more characteristics will be shown in a particular table. It's called a complex table. So whether two coordinate factors will be shown in a particular table, it's called a double table. And whether three coordinate factors will be shown, it's called triple table, and whether more than three characteristics will be shown in a particular table, it's called multiple table. So two coordinate factors are present, it's called double table. Three coordinate factors are present, it's called triple table, and more than three, it's called as multiple table. So means in two table means here two characteristics will be shown. In triple table means three characters will be shown, and multiple means more than three characters will be shown in the table. So examples. In the first one, so length and number of papaya plants is present, it is a simple table. So whether the plants belongs to according to sex, they divide into classified into two groups, one is male and the other one is female. So it's called as double table. And whether they are infected or not infected, so it's a triple table. And here whether they are infected or not infected, and means gardens also here we are separated. In A garden, how many plants are infected, and they belongs to male, and here they belongs to female. So here we can easily identify the characters. So length and number of papaya plants, this is the simple table or one way table. So here we have to add according to sex, okay, it's a male and female, means it is the another character, means it's a double table. Okay, so again here we have to mention whether they are infected or not infected. Okay, so length and number of papaya plants is the simple table, and whether we have to add according to sex, they are sub classified into male and female, it's a double table. And again we are add another column, infected or not infected, it's a triple table. And here we have to mention the particular garden area. In garden A, how many plants are infected, and in garden B, how many plants are infected, and how many not infected in garden A, garden B belongs to female, and again here also. So it's a multiple table, means here more than three characters are present. So this is the first character, second, third, and this garden A and B, this is the fourth character of a table. So means it's called as multiple table. And next one, general and summary tables. So this general and summary tables contains a detailed information, and those are not constructed for specific discussions. So means the general summary tables are contained a detailed information, and those are not constructed for a specific discussion. And this kind of tables are rarely used for the biological researches. So here we have one worked example. So in the year of 2007 and 2008, there were completely 83 fish ponds are present in a town. So here completely 77 were private ponds and 6 were of government ponds. Okay, and these 83 fish ponds are produced fishes of 5 species in quintal. Okay, we have to 5 different species were produced by these 83 fish ponds. And here we have the calculation part. So here the production will be mentioned in the quintals only. Okay, so in private ponds, labio produced 52 quintals of labio, and Vallago 8 quintals and Mistress 10 quintals and Etronustis fazilis 2 quintals and Katla 5 quintals. In the same way, government funds Labio produced 0 quintals and Vallago 2 quintals and Mistress 1 quintal and Etronustis fazilis 1 quintal and Katla 2 quintals. So this is the data we have to mention in particular general table. So here first we have to take how many species are produced. Okay, so here we have to mention different species of fishes. So completely 5 different species are there: Labio, Vallago, Mistress, Etronustis fazilis and Katla. Okay, and these are produced by the private ponds and also government, both ponds. So in private ponds, the Labio produced in 52 quintals, in government ponds it's a 0. In Vallago, produced in private ponds it's 8 quintal, and in government ponds it's 2. And Mistress produced in 10 quintals by the private ponds, and in government pond it's 1. And Etronustis fazilis 2 quintals and 1 quintal, and Katla produced 5 quintals and 2 quintals only. So overall completely 77 quintal of fishes will be produced by the private ponds, and only 6 quintal of fishes was produced by the government ponds. Totally completely 83 quintal of fishes will be produced in that particular town. So here we can easily explain the overall summary about the production of fishes. Okay, so it is the general and summary tables. It contains only detailed information only, but those are not constructed for specific discussions, and this kind of tables are rarely used for biological researches. And the next one, frequency tables. So there are two types of tables are there. One is the one-way table and the one is the two-way table. So one-way table means it is the tabular equivalent of a bar chart. A one-way table is the tabular equivalent of a bar chart, and the one-way table displays the categorical data in the form of frequency counts and also relative frequencies. Okay, so one-way table displays the categorical data in the form of frequency counts and relative frequencies. This one-way table distinguished from a table of two-way table because the data entries, based on the data entries, means in the one-way table they have only one variable, and in two-way table here the two variables are present. So one-way table shows frequency counts for a particular category of a categorical variable. One-way table shows a frequency for a particular category of a categorical variable. It's called frequency table. So here we discuss the frequency table for representing travel choices of 10 travel agency clients. Okay, so representing travel choices of 10 travel agency clients. So through the bar chart, so they refer USA 6 travel agency clients and 3 of Europe and 2 of Asia. So it is about the one-way table they present in the frequency. So USA 5 frequency and Europe 3 and Asia 2. So relative frequency tables means when one-way table shows relative frequencies means about percentages or proportions for particular categories or categorical variable, it's called relative frequency table. That means which is the particular categories of a category variable will be shows in percentages or proportions. It's called relative frequency table. So here USA proportion 0.5 and Europe 0.3 and Asia 0.2, and in percentages USA 50% and Europe 30% and Asia 20. And the next one, two-way table. So most of the statisticians are used these two-way tables, because these two-way tables and segmented bar charts to examine the relationship between two categorical variables. Why they are using means, it is examine the relationship between two categorical variables. Okay, so the two-way frequency tables, we have to take one example here. So here, favorite leisure activities of 50 adults. Okay, favorite leisure activities of for 50 adults. From those 50 adults, 20 were men and 30 were women. So here, because the entries in the table are frequency counts, okay, here the frequency would be count, that means it's a frequency table. So here the leisure activity for men, dance 2 members and sports 10 members and TV 8 members, and the leisure activities for women, dance 16 members and sport 6 and TV 8 members. That means these are the frequency counts. Okay, this table only counts the frequencies, hence it is called a frequency table. Okay, so here we have entries, the total row and total column are called as marginal frequencies. That means calculating these total rows and total columns are called marginal frequencies or marginal distribution. And the total entries of the body, okay, these total entries of the body of table, it's called joint frequencies. So next, two-way relative frequency tables. So here the relative frequencies in a two-way table, the table entries are called, that means these entries are called conditional frequencies or conditional distribution. Okay, so here we can count relative frequency for the whole table. So leisure activities of men, dance, sports and TVs. So here 0.04 we get. How can we get means, the total, how many members are there? 50 members are there. So how many men leisure activity is dance? Only 2 members. 2 divided by 50, we get 0.04. in same like that way, so we are getting all this data. Okay, so the relative frequency for the whole table, okay, it's a 1.00. that means men 0.40% and here 0.60 and here 1.00. again we are calculate in this way, also we get 1.00. that means the whole table answer will be, we get only 1.00. okay, it is about the relative frequency for the whole table we get. Okay, so here for rows only, okay, for rows means here we can calculate 2 by 20. Okay, and so here 2 by 20, so it's for rows only. So here we get 2 by 20 and 10 by 20 and 8 by 20 and here also 16 by 30 and 6 by 30 and 8 by 30. So in like that, so we get 1.000 for R all rows. And for columns, so for columns means we have to calculate in this way. Okay, so here the total 18, and how many are interested to their leisure activity is dance? Only 2 members, 2 divided by 18, we get 0.11. so like this we have to do all this. Okay, so it's about the relative frequency for, so it relative frequency for columns and this one for rows. Okay, so and the last one, segmented bar chart, means we can easily identify through the their separation. So this straight line indicate the sports, and this cross lines will be indicate the dance, and this empty line will be indicates the TV. So means for the men's, the dance is the leisure activity, these persons, and sport is the leisure activity, and this area will be indicates the TV as leisure activity for men's. For women's also same, it's about the one way and two way frequency tables. Thank you.